Hello, you're watching TelecomTV. I'm Guy Daniels, Director of Content. Reducing power consumption has become an imperative for mobile network operators. A collaboration between Red Hat, NEC and Intel has led to some dramatic savings in 4G and 5G networks in near commercial environments. Now, to find out how this has been achieved, I am joined today by Viplob Singhal, who is Head of Business Development, 5G Center of Excellence at NEC. Timo Jokiaho, who is Chief Technologist for EMEA at Red Hat. And Thomas Senhauser, who is Chief Technology Officer, Intel APAC. Hello, everyone. Good to see you all. Thanks so much for taking part in our program. Now, Viplob, can we start by you telling us about what you're doing with regards power saving for the user plane function, the UPF? And also, can you explain how NEC has achieved this reduction of over 30% in CPU power consumption for the UPF?
Sure, Guy. So maybe I can start off by saying that, as you were mentioning, you know, power consumption in telecoms networks is and has been a hot topic. And in the last 12 months, the pressure is even greater. And what we're seeing in the industry is that there's enhanced benchmarking and penalties associated by service providers for breaching consumption, because it's really become an integral part of the buying decisions. So any innovation to reduce power consumption is most welcome. And today, I think we'll talk about one such example. So what have we actually done with our partners, Intel and Red Hat? So the problem, what are we actually trying to solve here? Data traffic, as we all know, is highly variable. So there are sudden bursts and periods of inactivity. But the UPF applications themselves have very, very high energy usage and power consumption. Because there's this need for constantly sort of polling the network interface card, regardless of the actual traffic volume. So to solve this problem, we've accomplished a dynamic control of hardware resources in real time for optimal power consumption in a UPF performance test that we've done of a containerized standalone converged core network. And for this, we've used the Intel Xeon Scalable processor and its telemetry capability for the UPF's load determination logic. So using the integrated power management capability, the software agent, what we managed to do is actually reduce the CPU power consumption of the UPF by more than 30% in a dynamic near commercial environment. What specifically NEC did by working with Intel here is that we customized the load determination logic to fit the real commercial traffic conditions. And we implemented this logic in the DPDK that is incorporated into NEC's UPF. And moreover, NEC worked closely with Intel and established a mechanism for dynamically controlling the hardware resources of the Intel CPU.
Thanks very much, Viplob. Thomas, can you explain to us the role that Intel's Xeon Scalable processor telemetry plays in enabling the dynamic control of hardware resources for optimal power consumption in NEC's UPF?
Yeah, sure. I mean, the good story is, you know, that I said before, you know, this sustainability is a topic which is not only, you know, coming up the last couple of weeks, it's really the last 2 years now everybody's running around. And I think the key reason behind this is not only a heavy cost from an operational cost point of view, because the energy cost went up over the last 24 months. It's also everybody want to help, you know, getting a greener world. So I think this is really a key driver for us. From an Intel point of view, you know, with our Xeon next generation platform, we had that capability, you know, to manipulate the core, depending on the workload, since many generations. But as before, you know, especially in the UPF, in the core, main question was always, how can I get more performance out of it? So nobody really cared about the energy. And now it's changed. We have that function, as I said, you know, in previous version, and now we optimize that with our Xeon generation and next generation. And what that means is really, you know, we can move a certain level of core, which are not needed, into a kind of a sleep mode. So we call it, you see it in some documentation about the P core and C core, which has different value, how fast you can drive the core. You know, if the UPF says, hey, I don't need so much power anymore, you know, we can reduce 4 or 8 cores, and we reduce that, you know, in the case that we manipulate the frequency, and we can put it even into a sleep mode. And with, you know, next generation silicon, what we have today available, you know, we bring the time to manipulate that, you know, into the nanosecond. So it's not really, you know, anymore a big delay. And that's what we have demonstrated in the collaboration, you know, with NEC and Red Hat together in that, you know, pre-model of commercial ready solution.
Thanks, Thomas. This is all so positive. Could you go into some more detail for us about how NEC has customized the load determination logic to fit real commercial traffic, and also how it's incorporated it into the data plane development kit in the UPF?
Yeah, sure. I mean, I said before, you know, the UPF itself has telemetric data, which identify, you know, how much traffic is coming. And depending on that, you know, traffic model, which you have, you know, it communicates with the DBDK on telemetric data, which is an API. The DBDK version has to be 22 plus X, you know, to support that. And then with that, we can manipulate the silicon, the CPU, our Xeon CPU, to, you know, manipulate the different core depending on the request we have. And which is really important is, you know, we demonstrated that with the UPF, but you can use that also for other workloads. The principle is always the same. If you have a VNF or a CNF and they can communicate, you know, what is happening from their workload, we can always manipulate that. So I think it's a great example of a great collaboration between NEC, Red Hat, and Intel. But I think it's not limited, you know, to the core. We can do that really, as I said, you know, with any kind of workload. But of course, on the core side, we see it, there's a heavy, heavy energy savings. As said, you know, over 30% we have achieved. That's why it was a little bit of the low-hanging fruit on that side.
Indeed. Excellent. Thanks very much, Thomas. And Timo, how has the integration of Intel's UPF and the Red Hat OpenShift environment contributed to achieving energy efficiency and reducing power consumption?
Yeah, so I'll explain a little bit what we do in collaboration with NEC and Intel. So OpenShift container platform, first of all, it abstracts the hardware away from the application as much as possible, not completely, but as much as possible. And we need to have access to hardware low-level features like CPU cores and core partitioning and all these things. And also, we have access to energy efficiency and power savings operations like P states and C states mentioned by Thomas earlier to manipulate the CPU core frequencies based on the need of the applications. So we do that. We manipulate the power saving states, C and P states, to control power consumption. And this is, of course, done and has to be done in very close collaboration or cooperation with onboarded workloads like NEC UPF, because we do not want, we cannot compromise performance. We can manipulate these states as long as the performance is still there. Very important. What we also can do is, or we are doing, is that we can partition the multi-core CPUs into different domains, set of CPU cores, where one domain can be set critical domain in which CNP state logic cannot be done or used because of performance reasons. In another set of course, general purpose domain, the state logic can be used as much as the workload permits. This feature is very, very useful for RAN distributed unit use case, but also useful for UPF. Now, the other thing what we do related to energy savings is workloads scheduling, optimal scheduling, which OpenShift does using its own logic, but also has to be done in close collaboration with workload logic to achieve maximum power savings, but again, not to compromise the performance. Now, the last thing I'd like to just mention is the recent testing we have been doing with Intel and NEC on NEC UPF is that NEC UPF is providing telemetry information to Intel's infrastructure power manager, IPM, which in turn directs Red Hat OpenShift to manipulate CPU core frequencies based on UPF telemetry information, meaning busyness of the workload or load situation of the CPU cores. So this really leads to sizable runtime power savings, like 30% in this case mentioned by Viplop earlier.
Thanks, Timo. A lot of great innovation going on here. Finally, Viplop, could you update us on the latest activities around NEC's sustainability and power saving solution? And also, can you tell us more about how NEC works with ecosystem partners like Red Hat and Intel?
Sure. So just a few words. I mean, as we mentioned, we're discussing power consumption, and what NEC is doing is, be it on the core or the radio access network, what we're trying to do is we're looking at how we can actually build in power saving functions across the network, whether we utilize sort of the RAN intelligent controller or the service management orchestration functions at the network level, or whether we look at it from a silicon perspective. So just as an example, there's a lot of debate in the industry about acceleration techniques such as lookaside and inline, which is at the silicon level. And part of this debate is actually related to power consumption as well. So we're working with different ecosystem partners. We're working with Intel, of course. Red Hat plays a key role in terms of providing that cloud infrastructure. And the heart of all the development that we're doing, the topic of power consumption is a key consideration. In addition, I mean, obviously, we as a company take sustainability of our supply chains very, very seriously. We're platinum graded by EcoVadis, and we embrace the vision of, you know, being a greener, brighter world. And we share this with all our partners and customers. I think coming back to the packet core, the solution is very compelling because of its low carbon footprint, probably contributed by the energy consumption feature that we talked about. But we also recognize that the communication service providers themselves have a lot of value at stake to improve their own ESG needs. And there's a pressure for them to comply with the, you know, the tightening ecological regulation and sustainability targets that there are. So as partners with companies like Intel and Red Hat, I think we share that same vision and we work closely to collaborate to bring in those kind of solutions that help you know, all of us operate in a very green world that we all aspire for.
Indeed. Well said. Thank you, Viplop. And Thomas, this sounds like a very productive partnership you have here.
Yeah, again, I think it's great. I said before with Vipro, I mean, it's, you know, we also, from an Intel point of view, I think, you know, sustainability, you know, having a better CO2 footprint is a critical path. And we have that in our strategy by 2040. And we also, you know, creating, you know, the greenest silicon today in the market with our Sapphire Rapids fourth generation silicon. which has, you know, 98% reusability of how we produce, you know, the silicon. So I think it's sustainability is not only when we run it, as we demonstrated here in that case on the UPF, it's also how do we produce ingredients, you know, how green are they produced, then when we run them, you know, in an environment like a telco network, which is growing and growing and growing, you know, it's really important for all of us to work and collaborate together. And I think it's really also a collaboration which is needed in the industry, because it cannot be done by a single company. It's a collaboration, multiple companies working together. And then, you know, optimize that part. And then also on the recycling, you know, how do we bring that, you know, good back, you know, and recycle part of that at least, which we can bring together. So I think it's a journey as an industry we need to do. And I think all the three companies working here together demonstrate that. And I think, you know, we're looking forward for more partners joining us and really take that serious.
Thanks, Thomas. And Timo, final words from you on this collaboration?
Yes, absolutely. So, you know, currently in the telco networking, nobody can do everything on their own. We always need collaboration and cooperation between the companies, and in this case, NEC and Intel and Red Hat. And we as Red Hat, we just provide kind of tools and methods and features for workload vendors to use in energy efficiency way or in the domain. So we provide methods which can be used by the workload vendors. So again, collaboration is a key. It has been a key in the telco industry for a while, and it will be a key. Now, the final thing is, what I wanted to say is that Red Hat is an open source company, and everything we do has to be found in open source projects, many of those. And luckily, there are quite a few energy efficiency and power savings related open source projects out there, which we are contributing quite a bit in most of those. And once they mature, we integrate those projects into Red Hat OpenShift platform, and then we provide those features and commercially support those features. So again, we provide methods and tools, and close collaboration is a key.
Indeed. Thank you very much, Timo. Well, we must leave it there. It's just such an important topic. Absolutely fascinating discussion. Thank you all very much for taking part in our program today.